Hi students, welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. Today I'm going to teach you the percentages chapter, the fractions, how to convert fractions into percentages and how to convert percentages into fractions. This topic is very important for all the competitive exams which have quantitative aptitude as a section. You know, if you learn this concept, right, it'll be very easy for you to solve the data interpretation questions. Time and work, allegation, I mean, life would be very easy. So let's start. How to convert 1 over 2 into percentages? Simply percent. So let's break percent. Cent means 100. Percent. 50% means 50 per 100. Okay, so how to convert the value, the fraction 1 over 2 into percentages? Simply multiply it by a cent, that means 100. So simply it's 50, it becomes 50%. Similarly, if we want to calculate 1 over 5, multiply it by 100, it becomes 20%. Yep. In the similar way, 1 over 8, if we multiply it by 100, it becomes 12 to the power 1 over 2%. In the exam, for example, you want to calculate like what is the value of like we have the value of 1 over 9 is equal to 11 to the power 1 over 9%. What is the value of 3 over 9? Very important. What is the value of 3 over 9? Just try to calculate yourself. What we will do? Simply, we already have the value of 1 over 9, right? 1 over 9 is 11 to the power 1 over 9. What we will do? We will multiply. First of all, multiply 11 by 3. It becomes 33. Now we'll multiply the numerator, that is 1 over 9, and it becomes 3 over 9. So the answer becomes 3 over 9. 33 the power 3 over 9%, or you can write it as 33 the power 1 over 3%. Simple. Let's take another example. That was pretty easy because it was 3 over 9 is 1/3. Let's take another example. We want to calculate the value of 5 over 9. Simple. Simply 11 multiplied by 5, it becomes 55. Then you need to multiply this number, the numerator, with this numerator. So it becomes 55 the power 5 over 9%. Simple. As simple as it is. Let's take another example. What is the value of 3 over 11? Calculate. You need to calculate in percentages. I recommend you to please pause the video and try to solve the question yourself. 3 over 11, what is the value in percentage? So let's start. So let's check. You need to memorize this, learn this properly. I mean, just write it down and learn this from 1 over 2 to 1 over 30. Learn it. This is very important. I mean, this thing is a weapon in your hands, right? While attempting QT questions, this is a weapon. The value of 3 over 11. We have the value of 1 over 11, that is 9 the power. 1 over 11 is 9 the power 1 over 11. What will be the value of 3 over 11? Simply, we'll multiply 3 by 9. That becomes 27. Again, numerator 1 by 3. So this becomes 27 the power 3 over 11. So let's take another example. What is the value of let's say 6 over 11. What is the value of 6 over 11 in percentage? So value of 1 over 11 is 9 the power 1 over 11%. So we need to multiply it by 6. 9 multiplied by 6 is 54. And again multiply the numerator 6 over 11%. So that's our answer. So let's do some, you know, difficult question here. The value of 1 over 14 is 7 the power 1 over 7%. Let's try to make this thing complicated now. So what would be the value of 8 over 14 in percentage? So simply multiply 7 by 8. Now multiply 8 by the numerator. Now, this is the important point here. This value is 8 over 7. Numerator is greater than denominator. Now, we need to carry forward 1 here. It becomes 57 and deduct 7 from here. Becomes 1 over 7%. This is the right answer. Okay. So, let's take another example. You can use this concept in time and work, data interpretation, partnership, profit and loss. I mean, this is a very, very good weapon while in the exam. Very good technique. So let's take another example. We can take an example like, so we have the question like, what is the value of, let's say 7 over 12. What is the value of 7 over 12 in percentage? We have the value of 1 over 12, that is 8 the power 1 over 3%. Now to get this value of 7 over 12, let's multiply 8 by 7. Now multiply 7 by the numerator, 7. Now the numerator is greater than denominator. So it becomes, we need to carry forward 2 here because 3 2s are 6 and 53 power 1 over 3 percentage is our answer. So that's pretty good. So let's take it another way. So we had 53 the power 1 over 3 percentage and let's convert it into fractions. How do you do that? I mean, what's your plan? So just give it a look. Just by watching this, like 58 the power 1 over 3, how many 1 over 3s are there? Like obviously this is the one. I mean, how would you do that? Give it a look. Suppose you want to convert this to this. Just try to multiply. I mean, just pause the video and try to solve it yourself. Just give it a try. Just pause the video. Okay, now. So for example, whenever you get this percentage, you need to, I think when there is 1 over 3, you get this, like you have this number, right? You need to multiply, I mean, to the closest number, like 8 7s are 56. This is 7 is the closest number. So it should be like 12. You already have 12. If you multiply it by 7, it becomes closer to this number. So if by practice, you will learn this method. And this is a very, very useful method. I mean, you can use this in this method in almost every chapter, right? So let's take another example. Let's take another good example. Convert this percentage into fraction. How do you do that? Take a look. What is the value of 100%? The value of 100%. I told you in the beginning, percent. 100% is always 1. So here 300% and 12 the power 1/2%. 300% is 3 plus 12 the power 1/2 is 1/8. So this is 1. You can simply calculate this. 25/8 is an answer. Very simple. Let's take another example. Let's take a good example like 1/9 is 11 the power 1/9. So if we multiply it by 2, 22 the power, first of all, 11 the power 1/9 is 1/9. 11 the power 1/9%, right? If we multiply it by 2, let's multiply it by 2, it becomes 22 the power numerator multiplied by 2, 22 the power 2/9. So there we go. 1/9 multiplied by 2 becomes 2/9, right? So let's find the answer here. So 9 is here, 38/9 is our answer in the fraction. Let's do another question. These are very, very simple questions. Let's convert this into fraction. Just convert this percent into fraction. Very simple. This is 500% plus 28 the power 4/7%. So 5 is simple 5, 5%, and 28 the power 4/7. So give it a close look of the table. If you look closely here, 1/7 is 14 the power 2/7. So 2/7 is 28 the power 4/7. You need to do practice. You need to practice a lot. Just make your base, make your concepts really strong. So simple. 37/7 is the answer. Let's do one more example. Simple example. Let's take an example. Solve this into fraction. This is your turn. You need to solve this. Just try to solve this. Pause the video and solve this question. So let me start. 300% and 33 the power 1/3%. Simple. 3 plus 1/3. Very, very simple. Looks bit odd, but this is how it is. Very simple. I mean, this could be like 1 more concept. We have calculated the values like 5/12. You can easily find this value of 7/5, right? We can do this easily. But let me tell you a trick. If I ask you what is the value of like 11/12 or the value of like 7/8 in percentage. How do you calculate this? How do you calculate this? If I ask you what is the value of 12/13? Let's go another way. What is the value of 7/8? Instead of going through this 1/8 and multiply the whole thing by 8, let's do it by a simple method. 1 - 1/8. Simple. 1 is 100% and 1/8 is like this way. Very simple, 87.5%. A very, very simple method. So, I request all of you to practice this method, and please write this fraction on a piece of paper and read it every day. I mean, practice this method every day. I mean, whichever question you face. If you like this video, then please subscribe our YouTube channel. And if you want to buy our full-fledged course, you can buy our full RBI Grade B course or complete banking course. That course contains all the videos, test series, daily quizzes, and you know, live sessions. And you can buy this complete full-fledged course on www.bankexamstudy.com. The link is available in the description. I hope if you have any doubt, then please make a comment. Have a nice day.